But before I get to the final boss, I'm fighting a scientist. I just want to see what like sacrifices are. Ennis, you know, like Avatar: The Legend of Aang, GameCube game.
Mm-hmm.
It's like €30 here.
Jeez.
You know, it's actually pretty decent here.
I could probably buy it too, because I still have the game.
Oh, okay. I guess I've never seen a Beyblade game before, so I was like, oh, it's €10 too.
Alright, I'm not interested. I'm gonna fucking look that up later. It's like fucking... What is the game's name from Beyblade?
Hold on, let me go back. They also have Capcom vs. SNK2 here. They have Beyblade V-Force for like €10.
I am looking that up. I'm gonna put that on my watching later list, because I'm fucking interested. What the fuck is this?
I really wanna go to Gouda again, honestly.
What the fuck? Since fucking when does Beyblade have a fucking... What are you going to do? Are you gonna like fucking put microtransactions into the game just so you can like buy some new parts?
Okay, well, actually Girl of Darkness is sold out, which is why you don't see it. Like, probably why the price are so fucking high too. It's a rare game. I have the game though, I don't have to buy it.
Yes. Now you can sell it for $620.
No! Maybe I should. I mean, then again, I have to think of shipping costs too.
Add that onto your price.
The most evil thing would be if like I would make like Netgame buy it for like 100 euros and I would buy it for like 40 euros. The most evil thing. Nah, I'm not too much of a... Nah, I'm kind of like that of a dick, but I won't go that far.
Oh, look at that, Jazz. You got the most legendary status effect of the universal status effects.
And the last one turn.
Yes! I swear to God, I hate freeze in its fucking existence.
It's like... last for one turn, but when it happens to you, it will last for fucking ever.
Yeah. Look at that, the same fucking turn that it got frozen, it tossed out, meaning
it can attack. With my luck, the same thing is with confusion. Someone else uses confusion, I'm constantly confused, I get hit all three turns. I use confusion, nothing happens, nothing happens, and then, oh, stepped out of confusion. It's like, what the fuck?
It's like, I swear, oh man. But the worst part with freezes is so fucking rare. It's like, yeah, Ice Beam has a 10% chance of freezing. Yeah, I don't believe it. Do you?
I don't, nah, it's bullshit.
It's like, you could say, but maybe you don't use Ice Beam enough. Mate, Ice Beam is like one of the best fucking ice type boosts in the game.
You give it to basically every water type you have, honestly.
Yeah, it's like, flying type Pokemons? It's your bitch. Ground type Pokemons? Well, you're using a water type Pokemon, but might as well add some ice on it.
Best type Pokemon?
Dragon type Pokemon? Dragon Pokemon? In a heartbeat. You know?
I mean, that's why the ice shines.
Yes.
You have so many dragon flying type Pokemon, so shit, right?
Or that one dragon ground, or those two dragon ground type Pokemon. So it's like, it's just... And you're gonna tell me, it's like, oh, I've used it so many damn times, and it's like, not even once do I get a fucking freeze.
Well, anyway, it's time to fight the final boss, and I hope you're prepared, because the final boss is 6 shadow Pokemon.
Jesus.
Yes, the full team is shadow Pokemon.
It's a catch fest, alright? You got all the Pokeballs you need.
And funny enough, if you fight him again in like the post game, it's a completely different team because you catched all the Pokemon.
Nice, nice detail, I guess.
Yeah.
So, any specific stat you remember from this fucker? Oh, look at those eyes.
Leave it to luck. Because he comes with a Shadow Rhydon and a Shadow Moltres! Nou, awesome. I think you can assume what other two Pokemon he has on his team.
Alright, so we start off with one of the somewhat strongest like fire type Pokemon in the game. In terms of special attack set and whatnot.
Yeah. So, let's first talk about Rhydon, because let's just get him out of the way. Rhydon has 120 attack and 120 defense, 130 attack and 120 defense and 15 HP. This is all 45 and 40. So not really a good Pokemon.
It's actually a really fucking good ball Pokemon.
I guess it's a decent physical ball, but it's still kinda
Give it like an Eviolite, and apparently it can just be as annoying. Of course, don't put it against grass and water, and then you're fine.
Honestly, that's what I was about to say. It has this fucking squirt some water on it, and it's dead.
Yeah. Besides that, the next spawn on the list is somebody who doesn't like a little rock thrown at it.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, you want to talk? We don't want to talk about the moveset of Rhydon.
Rhydon's moveset. Yeah, but why not do it? It's pretty good actually, and funny.
Yeah, that's yeah. It's like so many moves. It's like flamethrower. He's got Quick Break. Because the flamethrower doesn't really matter. It's a special attack ship. His physical attack's pretty good, so you know, Quick Break is gonna be very nice. I mean, he also learns Thunderbolt, which again, you don't.
He learns. He also learns Surf.
He also learns. Yeah, I know. It's bucket. But honestly, one of the best things that he learns Beggarhorn, because Beggarhorn is very good in like competitive as well, especially for those psychic types. It's actually one of the reasons why he was like, it was how you in like Gen 1, right?
Yes, his typing make him immune, like basically immune to normal type moves.
This all over again.
His typing made him basically immune to normal type moves, followed up with like the fact that he has Beggarhorn and like decent and a good defense steps, just being annoying as a whole.
So yeah, but Gen 1 is really good. Just that, then. There's so many other Pokemon that can probably do what he does better.
Yes.
Moltres is the more interesting one, obviously, because he's a legendary. Now, obviously, he's also a Shadow Pokemon, so now he has, like, Shadow Fire Attack or something like that. I don't fucking understand why, but he has that. And with Special Attack of 125, Moltres is probably going to be the most dangerous Pokemon he has. I would say. He does have, like, okay stats for the rest. I say okay, but like for legendary stat, like actually his base stat is lower than fucking Salamence, so whatever. You know what his total stats are, Ennis?
Sure.
580. You know what Salamence's total stats are, Ennis?
15 points more.
600. Salamence is 600, Moltres is 580. Now, this doesn't mean that you can use Moltres in competitive here in this game, but I wouldn't really recommend it, because Moltres is just not really that good. It's not as bad in this game, he's at least usable. But he's so weak to walk, you know, you just throw a rock at him and he's dead. I have to hit him.
There's actually a move in this game. Rock throw. Yeah.
Anyway, he does learn Heat Wave, which is pretty cool, I guess, but I also learned at level 73, so... Whatever. Oh no.
Isn't his physical attack set pretty good though? Like 100 or something?
It's 100, it's pretty good.
Good luck, Jess, with this fucking battle. In the meantime, it's like.
Oh no, execute. Okay, so next Shadow Pokemon, execute. Executor is a pretty decent Pokemon with a special attack of 125. His HP stat is 95 and his defense stats are like special defense 75 and his normal defense 85.
Drink some water upside down.
After this part, baby.
Either that or try to hold your breath for like a minute. Oh, but it's fucking execute. It's like, I believe that also a pretty decent speed stat to boot. Biggest problem.
No, his speed stat is 55, it's bad.
Oh, never mind that. Well, also pretty good then. It's like, was it its HP?
It was a special attack set that was just really good, like 125.
And then the grass and psychic type. I guess the psychic type made him really good for
the whole. Well, in general, he's really good because he knows Razor Leaf, which is like always a crit.
That's right.
Because Gen 1 is stupid like that.
No, yeah. Gen 1 is stupid, indeed. Gen 1 had many stupid things going on.
Doesn't really learn any good moves though, like you. Should probably evolve him later. I think he evolves to like the Grassstone, Leafstone.
Leafstone.
Yeah.
And he also gets the Dragon form in later Gen. Which is probably my favorite form out of all. Giant palm tree's a fucking dragon.
Yeah. Funny. Anyway, you want to play the safety basketball for the. I mean, you can use it for Moltres if you feel like it, but I kind of prefer to save fit for the end. Personally, I would, you know, obviously he also has Articuno and Zapdos, so, you know. That's why I said save the Master Ball, because you're gonna fight, like, three fucking legendaries, and you want to at least make sure you can, like, 1v1 two of them that are at the end. Oh, he also has other Pokemon. Hold on, Tor. Tauros! He was a star in Gen 1, I think, right? Because he has such power.
Yeah, one of the best ones in Gen 1.
Yeah, he's pretty good. He's got like 110 speed and 100 attack. Because of how normal types are really powerful in like Gen 1, he's pretty fucking good. His defense stats aren't really that bad either. Special defense is 70, defense is 95, and HP is 75. The only thing that really sucks is like special attack, but well, you're gonna use my, you know. You don't need a special attacker in Tauros. I also know Shadow Sky for some reason. I don't really get the correlation, but whatever. Oh man, that's totally horrible.
He got a pretty good ability.
Ah, damn it!
Did Tauros die? I was looking at the stats, damn it. Did Tauros die?
Yeah. Like fucking Claydol critted him.
Damn it, Claydol, you were not meant to be the damage dealer.
Claydol, why did you betray me? I thought I could trust you.
If you're gonna do anything, help Jess with his fucking hiccups.
Use Psychic on my hiccups. Ah.
Come on, Jess, you can do it. Just try to control your breathing.
And it's another fucking Demon Slayer character.
Oh no, man, it's like I always manage to do it in like 2 seconds or something.
By the way, when are you going to come over tomorrow? Like,
I will try the usual time, but like I guess one, like before 1 o'clock or something.
Okay, good, it's fine. By the way, you guys might be wondering why the change in time. Why are we doing Pokemon XT Guild of Darkness now? I was thinking of doing it tomorrow, but I was like, nah, you know what? I want to give Anna some time to rest after we're done doing bullshit, whatever bullshit we do over here.
What are we going to do anyways? Like, I know the Switch is gone.
Oh, you wanted to watch Lord of the Rings, right? Or do you not
want
to watch?
Right. Yeah. No, it's fine. I just needed to know what exactly is going to happen.
Maybe you should bring like a PlayStation 4 controller, an Xbox 360 controller, whatever controller you use.
I don't know, it's like, with how long the Lord of the Rings might take, I want to get
if he's getting... Best, are we watching the extended version?
Well, apparently the extended version is the best one, so... Maybe I'll come a bit earlier, if anything.
That's a good idea. So, yeah. I was thinking of like going to Verhagen for food, I want to see if I like their food.
Sure thing. We could do that, so yeah, I might try coming like... Try to be there before 12 or maybe or something, because that's gonna take like 6 hours just to watch 2 films.
Well, I don't even think we're gonna watch 2 films. I think we're just gonna leave it at 1.
Alright, then not such a big deal to come at 1 or something.
Just we're watching 1 movie and then play some games late.
Yeah, I'll bring my PS4 controller or something.
Yeah. Oh man, this fight takes for fucking ever too.
Yeah.
At least Bolter's being... You know, I had such good luck in the beginning of this fight in like the first round. Because I caught like Bolter's in 1 go. And then like fucking like Claydol's like, no.
This is crit city, you know?
Right. Oh, my mouth is getting dry. I want to save up like drinking like in between parts. Because, you know, we're gonna... I don't know what we're gonna do. We're gonna like... I don't really know when this is over.
Isn't this part like the final part, or do we have like
a... Yeah, no, this is the final part.
Should be fine if you need anything.
Because I set the live stream for 14 on like 1925.
I've seen, yeah. I don't feel any biggie here unless you feel something about it.
Yeah, well, I also want to take in some painkillers because I always have a headache for some reason. I just want to make sure I'm fine. I also want to take in some vitamins.
It's fine. Oh boy, Articuno.
Articuno! Also dies in one hit by a walk.
That's the 125 special defense with 100 physical defense and 90 HP. A decent special attack to boot. Biggest problem with it is that it's fucking ice typing. Together with flying. Not having many good moves.
Now, since he has the lowest attack stats, I do recommend just like, not using the Master Ball on him, but using the Master Ball on Zapdos, because, you know.
Zapdos is king.
Zapdos Like, Moltres is like in, is, starts in the beginning, so you probably have already pretty healthy Pokemon, and you'll be fine for the most part. But your Pokemon being worn down like near the end, and like Zapdos and Articuno being the last two Pokemon he has, you might want to like catch the like Zapdos with the Master Ball because he has a higher special attack. Than Articuno. Fun fact: Articuno had a whole special stat of like 125. So he also had 125 special attack in Gen 1, with, and together with Blizzard, which was really fucking good in that game, Articuno was also like very, like, super amazing in that game.
Yeah. Nowadays it's just, you know, rocks scare him.
Rocks scare him.
On the other hand, Zapdos, oh man, Zapdos, he never gets old being like the top Pokemon of the generations.
Are we about Zapdos now? Okay.
Yeah.
Zapdos is really good, no matter the generation. I think partially it's really because of his typing too. Like, flying and electric is actually a really good typing. Because the only weakness electric has was like ground, and that's already eliminated. Now, it's now weak to rock, sure.
And ice, but whatever.
But does it really matter when he has like Roost, which is capable of healing like half his HP. And he also has like fucking, like, all the, like, his defense that's 85, his special defense is 90, and his HP is 90, which is means that he's overall pretty bulky. His speed is 100, which means he's also pretty fast. And he has a really high special attack. Actually, he has better stats than Moltres now, I'm looking at it.
Yeah. Zapdos is forever king, though. It's like the bulk makes him basically unkillable for most fights. Having the roost in later generations makes it so you have to like guess if he's gonna risk the roost to get a heal or.
The only bad thing about Zapdos in later gens is that he doesn't do any special flying type move.
Yeah.
But his attack is 90, so if you're just like playing, you can just use Drill Pack if you feel like it.
Yeah, basically. It's not like.
Do I recommend it for like the like post-game competitive like tournaments that is in this game? Yes, absolutely. I recommend Zapdos.
Man, he learns Heat Wave too. That's right, yeah. He learns Heat Wave.
Yes, so he does, so it's extra useful in this game.
It's like, not only does he have electric type moves, but he also has Heat Wave and Thunder Wave, making it a lot better for double teams.
It's not in Gen 3 though, is it?
I think it, maybe not in Gen 3. You're probably right with that one.
Yeah, not in Gen 3. Still, pretty good Pokemon.
He has like, what do I see here? He still has Thunder Wave and Thunder Bolt. And he has some screens if you want to be annoying with
it,
so.
Yeah, you can do Light Screen. And maybe Reflect too. Yeah.
It's Gen 4 probably where he gets, again, moved. Why I say Gen 4 is best Gen, because there he learns Heat Wave.
Yeah. fucking hell.
Still having that furious battle against the Hiccups.
Why? Why now?
So,
like, I ordered the hamburger and the cola together with the fries I was making.
Right.
I was like, man, I wanted to go, like, cause, but the bathroom doesn't bite back to where I am and, like, over there, so I was brought back home. But, you know, obviously, we don't go get, like, go next to, like, a fucking place so that I can order, like, buy food from, because I don't have any hamburgers right now. They didn't have hamburgers at the store, so my dad bought me like two hamburgers from the butcher himself. He did it on his own, but it's like I got some fucking hamburgers from the butcher. Try it out, man. It's like a creep. I'll talk about it probably in the 14th stream, because honestly, we've got a lot of things to talk about here.
Like your hiccups. No, anyway.
Stop. Oh, man. How? I was saying Orted, and I still lost. Man, I can't believe Xehanort was the main villain again. This keeps happening. What this can be? I like how he's smiling, even though he's supposed to be angry. I won't forgive. There's no forgiving you. Look at his face, he's still smiling. Grandmaster, don't. Soundtrack. But if I did that, our Shadow Pokemon data and our subordinates will be lost as well. Grandmaster, such things can be replaced. We must ensure our own survival. Yes, because I'm totally out here to kill you. Time to get stabbed, motherfucker. I've readied the helicopter for our escape. We've got to leave now. You're right. Wait! He teleported! Please wait. You're willing to sacrifice everyone so you can escape? You should be ashamed. Ashamed? Clinging to foolish pride will guarantee Cypher's demise. He's saying that with a fucking... Look at this fucking smell, though. Cypher must survive. This is our first duty. The Grandmaster feels the same way. He does? Yes! Oh, yeah, totally convincing. What are you saying? The Shadow Pokemon Factory has been destroyed. XT-001 was defeated. Nothing remains of Cypher. Silence! Cypher will live forever! If only this child hadn't... Grandmaster, please, give us the order to blow up Citadel Dark Owl. Yes, it can't be helped. Don't be cautious, child. Stop! Let's put a stop to this. Father! Nanny? Don't call him father, call him the Grandmaster. Father, you've lost sight of what is important. You got carried away by this whole Grandmaster nonsense. It isn't possible to take over the world by producing powerful Pokemon. Just think of this child. This child's pure heart won out over XT-001. You were in the wrong.
We were
silence. Not. Silence, silence. Why aren't you showing some spine? We've come so far. Cypher is finished, father. You yourself should know that more than anyone. Oh.
Oh shit.
I'm gonna do something in the next game. No, you're not. What? This is how it should be. The loss of the land will render judgment on what we have done. Oh, everything I did, all of it was a mistake. He got norted, he can't help it. Thanks to your courage, we are finally able to wake from our nightmare. Thank you. You have nothing to fear from us ever. You should return home to your family. Let us meet again, too. The next time we battle, it won't be us mortal enemies. I will look forward to it.
That's nice.
And that's the end of the game. We did it, Ennis. We stopped Cypher forever.
Oh, yeah.
Now, look at this low quality FMV. Look at this. Look how bright the sun is.
Look at it. They had put more effort into this FMV than Sword and Shield did into their game.
Ennis, that's like so fucking mean. How dare you compare a good game to a clearly Nintendo 64 game?
Well, you know, it's like I sometimes forget that Sword and Shield was made for that console, you know?
Yeah, it's not made for the Switch, it's made for the N64. They just have it lying around for the longest time, like, hey, we can use it now.
Yeah.
Anyway, Jovi is happy to see us, whatever, I don't care.
She's probably just gonna call us stupid at everything else.
Mom's tits are pretty big now I think about it. Anyway.
Yeah, that's nice, just got his priorities straight.
Concept, what are you doing here?
Fuck.
I also want to be in the picture. I fought two. Okay.
Sure you did.
Anyway, we can't save, so we cannot do the post game, so we just have to talk about the credits. Anyway, should we talk about the game? Who wants to go first?
Yeah, you go ahead. I don't have much to say really.
So this game, like the question will be really just like, is it better than Colosseum? I wanna say in a sense it is better. Like, it doesn't fit. The thing is though, like, it does improve upon certain things. Like, there's a lot more Pokemon to choose from, for one thing. And because of that, you know, making teams is a lot more interesting. A lot more Pokemon are also really good, actually. So, it doesn't feel like you're, like, stuck with really bad Pokemon throughout the entire game. So, that's one positive. But, if it's, it's not really, like, there's a massive improvement over Colosseum, though. And now, the battle system can still be pretty fucking slow. And yeah, honestly, that's the biggest problem. And to make things worse, like, catching all of these shadow Pokemon gets really tiring. This game is, like, 10 hours longer than Colosseum. You can also, like, tell from our parts count, because, like, this one is, like, 31 parts. You know how long, like, Pokemon Colosseum was, Ennis?
How long?
22.
Huh.
Yeah, I thought it was 32, but no. And you know what's weird? This game feels short. Yeah, at the same time, feels very tiring. Besides, it was also longer than Colosseum. I was thinking about it, why is that? And it's like, this game doesn't really do much different for Colosseum. It has some quality of life improvements. But in the end of the day, the reason why it's so long is because you have to catch so many Shadow Pokemon. And I actually do want you to catch the Shadow Pokemon, because that's how you get Dragonite. You only get Dragonite if you catch all the shadow Pokémon. So if you want to fully complete the game, you have to catch all the shadow Pokémon. And I think if you play this game normally without doing that, the game can be better, can be a more fun experience than Colosseum. I think this game can, you know, again, with more Pokémon to choose from and more things to do in this game, I think the game can be a bit more fun. But if you're gonna go for a complete, like, you know, for a complete playthrough, this game is more tiring than Colosseum, I find. There's just too many shadow Pokémon to catch, and like battles take forever because of how many shadow Pokémon you have to catch in one battle, especially later on. And does it help that I already played Colosseum last year? So now that I play this game right after Colosseum, I just feel very exhausted. I do not recommend playing this game at all after Colosseum. I think you should wait like a good amount of time before you get to this game after Colosseum, because otherwise you're just gonna get really fucking exhausted. And when it comes to the battles being long, you know, I don't think the problem is like how long the animations take. I just think how certain things are directed. Like when there's like the weather effect that hurts all Pokemon, just get like constantly like, oh, this Pokemon got hurt. Oh, that Pokemon got hurt. It's like, it feels like it takes longer than it needs to do. And that's what makes it so tiring. Just all of that. And it's not like the story is that much better either. Like, I think Colosseum has a little more interesting story with more, well, I don't think all the villains are interesting, but the main villain was definitely a surprise to me, right? I didn't see the main villain coming at all in like Colosseum, but the next Eagle of Darkness, it was already obvious. You already know what's going to happen. And I think that also makes the story feel less interesting, because you already know. They're trying to make the same like plot twist, but it just doesn't work for me in this game. Anyway, that's my opinion. What does Ennis think of it?
Well, the soundtrack does seem to be like somewhat similar to like the first game, as far as I remember, right?
Yeah.
And in terms of its gameplay, I can't remember. Yeah, you know, yeah, there were some quality of line changes that I noticed, like for example how you have new shadow moves going on and whatnot, right?
And you know, I like the purification shit as well.
Yeah, those were really nice additions, and the list of Pokemon's being increased to give you more choices and whatnot, which could have been better if it wasn't Gen 4 mechanics, but that's for another discussion.
And it's the same thing I said about Colosseum, though, to be fair.
Yeah, and then there is that one thing I have to absolutely agree on, was like, the pacing in battles isn't done well. It could have been done much better. And the story has some, it is neat, though it has some things that are like interesting, it's stupid, better yet, but I guess it does look like some amount of, some form of a fun game, but because I didn't play it really, it's like I can't say much.
But if you were to like compare this to Colosseum, what would you rather play, now that I showed you both games?
I'll have to think about it.
Either way,
more options, I'll probably go for the fucking second game.
Yeah. Anyway, if you're not planning to like do the full game, like to complete, like fully complete the game, if you're just gonna go for like the main story, I think XD Guild of Darkness can be just fine. If you didn't like Colosseum, though, I can't say that you should play this game either, because if you don't like Colosseum, you're probably not gonna like this game either, because it doesn't really do anything different for the most part. Yeah.